Hey, this is Carla from the Butcher Baby.
This is George Corcoran Fisher from Cannibal Corpse.
Hey, this is Rex from Kill Devil Hill.
It's Wednesday 13.
This is Dad from Double Dobby.
This is Odorous from War. You're listening to RABID NOISE
on RABID Radio.
Turn it up.
Welcome back to RABID NOISE on RABID Radio. That was the Primeval Dark from Insomnium. And joining me on the program now from the band is Niilo Sevänen. And great to have you with us tonight, man.
Thank you very much.
Well, you're just about to tour here next month with The Haunted for your first trip down under. Now, when you think of Australia, what is the first thing that pops into your head?
kangaroos, probably. of course, we've seen a lot of Australia from television, but none of us has ever visited the place. So we are really excited to get there. And hopefully we have time to do some tourist stuff as well and see some of the some nice places there, or your exotic animals, or whatever. we are really excited to get there. Yeah,
well, we're excited to have you guys down. You know, finally we get to see you guys play down here, and it's one hell of a double bill. You know, with The Haunted, of course. Have you toured with those guys before?
Actually, not. I think we've seen them live many times, but we don't really know the guys, so. But I'm pretty sure it will be very good. And normally we get along with the Swedish guys really well, though there's this rivalry between Finland and Sweden. But in real life we are very good friends, so I'm sure it will be very good. Good. And it's a great band, of course.
Oh, of course. And you know, both you guys are great bands. So you know, you share a lot of fans down here, I'm sure. So it's going to be such a great tour, man. So. Onto your album, you know, your sixth studio album, Shadows of the Dying Sun, was released last year and was loved by fans and got heaps of praise from the press. Which track off it has been getting the best crowd responses live?
Oh, that's a tough one. We played almost all the songs live, and While We Sleep works live, and Ephemera, Blackheart Rebellion. It's hard to pick just one track. I think many of them work really well in a live situation. And usually when we arrange the songs and compose the stuff, we always think about the live situation as well. And the songs have to work not just in studio, but also when we play them live just for guys. So,
are you working on a follow-up to the album?
Yeah, slowly but surely, but there's so many tours now that it's a bit difficult because you need some time to do the composing stuff and just relax and be with your guitar and just play. And it doesn't work in a touring environment, really. It's too hectic and you have to concentrate on too many things. So when we get a little break, I think we're going to really focusing on composing the new stuff, but I'm sure next year we're gonna release something new, so it's in the works.
Awesome, man. I can't wait to hear what you guys are coming up with. Well, you know, as a singer myself, one thing I can't do is I can't sing and play at the same time, no matter how many times I've tried, man. I'm just too uncoordinated. Do you have a trick? Have you got a tip for guys like me?
Well, of course, you just have to practice, and first practice the song really well with your instrument so that it comes kind of naturally, and then try to start singing on top of it. But of course, another thing is that don't make it too difficult. So, for example, my bass lines live, I have to like straighten them up a little bit. I can't play all the stuff that I'm doing in studio because I have to sing at the same time and mosh and do a lot of things live. So you have to be practical and play a little bit easier stuff while you're singing. That's the secret.
looks like I'm going to have to take some of those tips. Keep trying.
Yep.
Instead of throwing down the guitar and just going nut.
Definitely.
So, you know, you've toured the world and played some massive festivals. Where do you think Insomnium has gotten the best response?
Well, that's a tough one. All over the world, we had really good audiences. it's very hard to pick. Japan was very good for the first time when we were there. Canada is always great. Eastern European fans are always crazy, and Switzerland is awesome, and many places in USA are very good. So it's hard to pick just one place. But I'm sure Australian fans will be great, and I've heard good things about your metal scene there, and really looking forward to it.
Well, it looks like we're going to have to leave you with something to remember us by, make you come back.
Yeah, exactly. we're counting on that, yes.
Well, we definitely hope to see you guys come back again. So what's next for Insomnium after you two are down here in Australia?
Well, summer festivals, and then we have a headliner tour in USA and Canada in August and September. We're going to be busy, and some more tours coming in the autumn, but they haven't been like confirmed yet, but there's a lot of things going on, and we really hope to get to South America as well with this album now finally, so that we could say that we played on every continent. Well, not Africa yet, but then we would have conquered the world almost.
Well, it sounds like you're going to.
Yes, that's the plan, of course. Nothing less.
Awesome, man. Well, we're going to go to the track Revelation off Shadows of the Dying Sun now. Thanks so much for taking the time to chat to us tonight, and we'll see you and the Haunted at the Hi-Fi in Brisbane on May 14th.
Awesome, we'll do that. Thank you very much.